Hello students, I am Sachin Prakash and I teach and mentor students in chemistry for IIT JEE. I believe that the real confidence which is required to crack this IIT JEE exam will come only when you are confident in tackling good problems. And that clarity and understanding of concepts will only develop when you are really comfortable in handling these problems. So this video contains the paper discussion which I have recorded conducted in my classes online. Okay, and a lot of good doubts are there which I have discussed here. It will be helping you people in understanding, developing an understanding in how to approach and tackle good problems. Okay, and if you like this, you found this paper discussion video to be useful and interesting, you can like, comment and subscribe to this channel, which will surely motivate me to add some more useful paper videos of this type. Okay, because ultimately it's this is just an effort, honest effort, small honest effort from my side to help the student, help my students as well as other students also in their IIT JEE preparation. So let us begin with this paper discussion. Okay,
so today we are going to discuss WTA 9 paper. Okay, so this is the paper in front of you. Okay, so this is a paper which is based on 2017 paper 1. Okay, so first section consists of the multiple correct questions, then you have integer type questions, and then you are having 3x3 matrix match. Okay, three column. So we'll be looking into the questions today. Okay, so let us start with question number 19 to 21. Any doubts in 19 to 21?
All the questions.
All the questions.
Yes.
Okay. So you see, question number 19. We are starting with question number 19. Okay. Yes. Yeah. So you see, it is given pH of a 0.01 molar acid is 2. So this means that 0.01 molar is giving 10.01 molar H plus. That will happen only when dissociation is 100%. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This means it is a HX is a strong acid.
So we avoid breaking.
Huh? Why it is breaking? Or not?
It's fine. Okay. It's fine, sir.
Okay. So, yeah, it will be good only. So, HX is a strong acid. It is clear because all of HX, is, if it dissociates, if alpha is equal to 1, then only you will get 0.01 molar H plus. Okay. If alpha is tending towards 1, this means it is a strongly reactive species. Okay. Next, we are talking about 0.01 molar salt, ACL. Now you see, if I'm writing the hydrolysis equation for A plus plus H2O will give AOH plus H plus. If this dissociates completely, reacts completely, then only you will get 0.01 molar H plus and a pH will be 10 power minus 2. pH will be equal to 2. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
This means all of all A plus has been converted into AOH. Okay, this means A plus is undergoing, has a very strong hydrolysis tendency. And if A plus is having very strong hydrolysis tendency, means it is coming from a weak base. Are you getting my point? Because only weak base will give cations which will have strong hydrolysis tendency. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So answer. So only C is the correct statement. HF is a strong acid and AOH is a strong weak base. All other statements are wrong. Partial hydrolysis with alpha will be less than 1. Are you getting a point? But it is not undergoing partial hydrolysis, it is undergoing complete hydrolysis. Everyone is clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so then we move to question number 20. Now in question number 20, you see, you have Fe3 plus, you are putting Fe3 plus into a solution of AlOH whole thrice. Okay, now let us say that Fe3 plus takes OH minus and you get FeOH whole thrice plus Al3 plus. Then this is a reddish brown precipitate. Now, whether this forms or not will be depending on the K of this reaction. Now, we know the KSP values for all the three, so we can try to predict it. Now you see, I can write, I want Fe3 plus on the reactant side, so I write Fe3 plus plus 3OH minus, giving FeOH whole thrice solid. The K for this reaction will be 1 by KSP of FeOH whole thrice. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And you see, AlOH, I want AlOH whole thrice also on the reactant side. So I can write this reaction. AlOH whole thrice gives Al3 plus plus 3OH minus. So for this K2, I can write as KSP AlOH whole thrice. Can I write it? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If I add these two equation, I will get my this equation. Yes or no? If I add 1 and 2, I will get this equation.
Yes.
So that is what we have done here. So K for this equation will be K1 into K2. It will be KSP of AlOH whole thrice by KSP of FeOH whole thrice. Okay. Are you getting up to this?
Yes, sir.
Once you are getting this, then if you calculate the values, it will come out to be 1 by 3.2 into 10 power 5. Now you see the key for this equilibrium is 10 power 5. This means that this reaction is going towards completion, almost. This means all of Fe3 plus is now precipitated as FeOH whole thrice. Are you getting my point? Yes, no?
So once repeated, sir.
See, if I am adding these two equations, I will get K to be 10 power 5.
Yes, sir.
So this means that this reaction is complete?
Yes, sir.
This means all of Fe3 plus has been converted into FeOH whole thrice?
Yes, sir.
So you will be getting reddish brown color. So the color of suspension will change to reddish brown. Because of?
Sir, why not AlCl3 is produced?
AlCl3 is soluble. Okay. AlCl3 is soluble. And that is why Al3 plus and Cl minus will remain independently in the solution. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So always remember this thing, that lower KSP salt will precipitate out preferentially in a spontaneous reaction. Okay, so you see, initially I was having a salt which was having higher KSP and I added an ion through whose reaction gives me a lower KSP salt. So that reaction will be a spontaneous reaction. Are you getting the point?
Yes.
Okay. So, if I have added Cr3 plus into solution of AlOH whole thrice, the reaction won't be spontaneous. Are you getting my point? If I'm writing Cr3 plus plus AlOH whole thrice and CrOH whole thrice plus Al3 plus. I guess Cr3 plus is having lower solubility product. Okay, then AlOH whole thrice. So it will not precipitate, you know, as salt with higher KSP. Are you getting my point? So for this, alpha will be less than 1. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 20 is clear. After that, 21 is not a doubt? Or is it a doubt? Salt of a weak acid and its cation or anion. Weak acid, weak base plus its cation or anion.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think A, B and D. D is a combination of two salts only. So that is why D is not a buffer. You needed NH4OH to make it a buffer. Are you getting the point?
Yes. So why not C?
Because it is a strong acid. Okay. So this is done. 22 is a doubt.
Yes, sir. Sir, option C.
Yeah. You see, when you have a diprotic acid, I have given you the whole process. So I have told you that the concentration of H plus will be something which will be coming from the first step only.
Yes, sir.
H2A is going to give HA minus is giving A2 minus. Sorry. Okay, just 1 minute. Okay, now you see this is Ka1 and Ka2. I have given you the result that the concentration of the second species will be equal to Ka2. This I have given or not? Remember?
Yes, sir.
And I have also given that the H plus concentration will be something which will be decided by the first step only.
Yes.
Okay, so we are using it. The pH of the diprotic acid is under root of Ka1C and it is 10 power minus 3. So from this, C is 0.1, so you will get Ka1 to be 10 power minus 5. Are you getting the point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, and second is A2 minus would be Ka2 to be 10 power minus 5. Okay. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
So these are the two things. Now, pK2 minus pK1 will be 7, not 9. So D is incorrect and concentration of H plus is 10 power minus 3 molar, not OH minus. So B is also incorrect. Getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So 22 is done. 23.
No doubt.
23 is not a doubt. Yeah, it is a pretty simple question. Okay, I think you can see it. Basically, you are having HCl and you are adding HCl to a solution which is already having NH4OH and NH4+. HCl is H+, it will react with the base part of the thing. So I think we have done these type of questions in the class also. Are you getting a point? So 20, 10, 30... This will react completely, so you'll get 10, 0 and 40, and then you can use the basic buffer formula to find pOH and then pH. Everyone is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. 24, is it out?
Option C.
Yeah, 24, option C, it should be 0.1 molar if you want to get the answer.
Yes, sir.
So it is going for correction. There are two mistakes here. Did you have 10.9 here in the paper?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this part though I can't claim, but this one is totally wrong. Okay. Answer will be A and B only. Okay. I think the process is really simple. You write HA plus OH minus giving H2O plus A minus. K is given to be 10 power 9. So if you write K, K can be written as K by KW. So K can be will be 10 power minus 5. Which is option A. And 0.1 molar HA, the pH will be 3.5. 0.1 molar A minus, pH will be 8.5. Okay, so this is done. So 24 is going for correction.
Option D.
KB for BOH.
It will get 10 power 5.
It's saying for weak base BOH is 10 power minus 4. Then the equilibrium constant for neutralization of HA with BOH. Okay, so let me check this. Okay. So if I'm writing HA plus BOH and it is giving B plus plus A minus plus H2, then K for this reaction will be concentration of B plus into concentration of A minus by concentration of HA into concentration of BOH. Okay, now you see if I add H plus and OH minus up and H plus and OH minus down. Then you see this and this will meet KB. Yes or no? B plus, OH minus and BOH will make KB. And A minus, H plus and HA will make K. By this will be KW. So KB into K, KB is how much? 10 to the power minus 4 into K is how much? 10 to the power minus 5 by 10 to the power minus 14. This will be 10 to the power 5. Wrong. So that is why it is wrong. Okay. 24 is done. 25 is a doubt.
25 first one.
Yeah. 25 first option is correct because you see I checked into the sources. You see, borate is an amphiprotic. Will react with both H plus as well as OH minus. When borate is reacting with H plus, we'll get weak acid H2B4O7. Which is tetraboric acid. Okay. And if you are reacting it with base, it will react with base also. Okay. Then it will give BOH whole 4 minus. Okay. If you want to balance this whole equation, you put 4 here. Okay. Then you balance charge. Total charge is like 4 minus here. So you put 2 OH minus here. And you then balance the number of oxygen atoms, which is 16 on this side. And 9 on this side, so you want to add 7H2. Now it is totally balanced. Are you getting a point? So since it will react with both strong acid as well as strong base, it will behave like a buffer. Are you getting a point?
Sir, it is multi-correct, no sir.
Is it the consider?
No, what I am saying is, are you getting that borax will act as a buffer?
Sure.
Yeah. So once that is clear, all other options are a combination of acid and anion. So it will act as a buffer. Okay. This is like, see, sodium citrate, you are having 3 acidic hydrogen. So you can treat it like an S3A. So trisodium means that it is A3 minus. And disodium is it is HA2 minus. So these two will act as acidic buffer. Are you getting a point? See, you have to model this question to suit the things which you already know. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
The structure is not required, but they have given it so that you can at least apply whatever you know. Okay, so it is having 3 acidic hydrogens, so you have to think along those lines. Don't worry, you know, with exposure, you would be able to do these type of questions also. And last case, you see, NH2 is an NH3+. It will be also acting as a buffer.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so answer is D, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay.
Sir?
Yeah.
It is multi-correct, no, sir.
Yes, sir, it is multi-correct.
should be correct.
Okay, yes, yes, yes. So by that way, so 2, 3 is correct, 2, 3, 4 is correct. Yeah, all the four options are correct.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is going for correction. Okay. 26. Oh, no. 26 is here. Yeah. Is it down?
One
explain. Okay. You see, Fe2 plus plus S2 minus. It is saying that the equilibrium constant is 10 power 17. Okay. What do we mean by this? We mean that the reaction is going to completion?
Yes.
Okay. So what I will do is that I will first do the complete reaction and then I will analyze the dissociation of the FeS. Because for that, K will be like 10 power minus 17. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So you see, when you are mixing equal volumes, okay, of Fe2 plus and 0.2, the volume will become double, so concentration will become half. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
If the concentration becomes half, then in the final volume, the concentration of Fe2 plus will be 0.06 by 2 and the concentration of S2 minus will be 0.2 by 2. Yes or no?
Yes.
So it is 0.03, 0.1. We are starting with these two concentrations. Obviously, this is a limiting reagent, so you will be getting 0.07 at the end. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we and you will be getting FeS precipitate. Now, FeS is solid, so I have not written its moles. Okay, but if you are, when FeS is dissociating, you are having S2 minus to be 0.07. So let us say that its solubility is S. Then Fe2 plus will be S. And S2 minus will be S plus 0.07? Yes or no? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
See, the sulfide ion concentration. Suppose FeS was alone in the solution. Then what will be the sulfide ion concentration? It will be 10 to the power minus 8, something like that. Yes or no? KSP is equal to S square when only salt is there in this case. Getting my point? So if only salt was there, then the sulfide ion which would have been generated would have been like 10 to the power minus 8 with under root of this whole thing. Okay. Compared to that, 0.07 is a huge quantity.
Yes.
So I can neglect S with respect to 0.07? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So once I write this, I can write S into S plus 0.07 is equal to KSP. Okay. And S, this will be basically 0.07 only. I can write S is equal to 1 by 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 17. It will come out to be 8.93 into 10 to the power minus 7. Now, since it is an integer type question, so we'll take the nearest integer, which is 9. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So, after this question number 27, is the doubt? Okay.
No, sir.
Now, in 27, it is easy on, you know. Again, the same concept is there when you are mixing equal volumes, then the concentrations will become half. And then you can just do the things. Put the expression in Ka. H plus is a strong acid, so it will decide the, HCl will decide the H plus concentration. And acetate ion will not dissociate that much because Ka is like 10 to the power minus 5. So you can get acetate ion concentration. The only thing in this question is that is it given the same way it is given here? Because here they are not asking find 200 ml of 0.1 molar acetic acid is mixed with 200 ml of equal volume of equimolar HCl solution. So concentration of acetate ion is not mentioned here. Are you getting a point? Means in the statement. Other than how will you know what you are calculating? Are you getting my point? Yes or no? Was it mentioned in the original paper?
No, sir.
No. If it is not mentioned, then I will give it for correction.
It was mentioned, sir.
Mentioned, sir.
It was mentioned?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I won't give it for correction. Okay. So, this is done. 27, 28 is easy. Carbonate and bicarbonate, so Ca2 will be the relevant acid dissociation constant. So you can write pKa2 plus log of carbonate by bicarbonate ion. Are you getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
29 is easy. The concentration of Ag plus will be decided by AgNO3.
Yes, sir.
Okay. 30th?
Explains.
Okay, 30th, you see, in an alkaline solution, on a basic solution, the red litmus will turn blue. You have to see which of these solution will give an alkaline solution. So you see, NaCN, the CN minus will give alkaline solution on hydrolysis. Na plus won't undergo hydrolysis. KCl, both cation and anion won't undergo hydrolysis. In this case, you see, there will be equal. Now, in this case, CH3CO minus NH4 plus. You see, acetic acid is having a K of like 1.8 into 10 power minus 4. 5 and NH4OH is having KB of 1.8 into 10 power minus 5. They have not given this data, no? Yes or no? So you see pKa and pKb will be same here. And it is a, what do you call as, salt of a weak acid and a weak base. So pH will be like 7 plus half pK minus pKb, it will be 7 only. Are you getting my point? Yeah, so data is not given, so I will recommend this also for, you know.
Hello?
Yeah.
Once explain for NaCN and KCl.
See, NaCN consists of, you have to see from where the cation is coming. Cation is coming from NaOH and anion is coming from HCl. This is a weak acid. So its anion will undergo hydrolysis. This is a strong base, so its cation will not undergo hydrolysis. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Same we will be using in all the cases. K plus is coming from KOH, Cl minus is coming from HCl. Both are strong acids and base, so no hydrolysis. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Sir, except CH3CO(NH4), why can't NaH2PO4 base?
Yeah, NaH2PO4, you see, the data is given here. H2PO4 minus the, it is an amphiprotic species. So pH will be what? pH will be Ka1 plus Ka2 by 2. So pKa1 is how much? 3 plus 8 by 2. So the next solution will be slightly acidic in nature. Are you getting a point?
They have given NaH2PO4.
Huh?
In solutions, they have given NaH2PO4.
They have given NaH2PO4. No, they have given Na2HPO4. We are coming to that. You see?
Yes.
Okay. So NaH2PO4 will be acidic. Zn2 plus will make the solution acidic. Okay. PO4 3 minus will make the solution basic. So this will be one of the options. Fe3 plus will make the solution acidic. So this is not an answer. CO3 2 minus will make the solution basic. So this is one of the choices. NH4 plus will make the solution acidic on cationic hydrolysis. Okay. NaSCO3. Now here you have bicarbonate ion, which is again an amphiprotic ion. So pKa1 plus pKa2 by 2, it will be 8.5. Are you getting a point? So this will be turning red litmus blue. Then Na2C2O4. Now you see, if you're talking about Kb, Kb will be what? For C2O4 2 minus, it will be 10 to the power minus 1 minute. H2C2O4, you are having, see, the second step, Na2C2O4, it is coming from a weak acid. Are you getting my point? H2C2O4 is a weak acid. So its cation will be undergoing hydrolysis. Anion will be undergoing hydrolysis. Are you getting my point? I am talking about the second step. HC2O4 2 minus to C2O4 2 minus. Are you getting my point? K is 10 power minus 5. Yes or no? So C2O4 2 minus will undergo hydrolysis, anionic hydrolysis, so the pH will be basic. And finally, Na2HPO4. So see, Na2HPO4 is having HPO4 2 minus, which is an amphiprotic anion. So we'll be taking Ka2 and Ka3 for HPO4 2 minus. So 8 plus 12 by 2, it will be pH will be 10 in this case. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Everyone is getting it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So with this, question number 30 is done. Okay. So you see, most of the paper is done. Now, 3 by 3. Now in 3 by 3, so when I started to analyze this paper, I started with 3 by 3 only, because only this is the interesting part in the whole paper. So let us start. Okay. So you have column 1 in which you have different salts, and in column 2, the hydrolysis constants are given. And column 3, the expressions for pH is given. Okay. Now, what are the rules which we have studied in hydrolysis? Salt of strong acid and strong base will not undergo any hydrolysis. The first column is strong acid plus strong base salts. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that will not undergo any hydrolysis. Only this is correct. All others won't apply.
Yes, sir.
And what is the pH?
7.
So the first combination which is correct is 1, 2 and R. Okay. Second, yes, is salt of weak acid plus strong base. So weak acid and strong base, this will undergo anionic hydrolysis. Weak acid will give anion, which will react with water.
3.
So 2 will be going with 3. And 3 will be going with
P.
Okay. So 2-3-P is a correct combination. Third, this is a salt of a weak base and strong acid. So this will undergo cationic hydrolysis. So hydrolysis constant will be Kw by Kb. Yes or no? And then this will go to?
Yes.
Yes. And first, final, it is strong, weak base plus weak acid. A weak acid plus weak base.
4Q.
So 4 will go with 4 and then it will go with Q. You see, this is relatively simple. You have only 4 correct combinations. Now you can do all the questions. Strong acid, strong base, 1, 2, R. Okay, weak base, strong acid.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is easy. Okay, so 3 questions, you know. Now this one is a more tricky one. Actually, it's not tricky one, but they have given answers wrong. Okay, so let me go through it one by one. First, let me explain what are the cases. Here, we are not going to figure out all the correct combinations. Why? Because they have given different salts in different questions. So rather than that, for each salt, we will see the options which combination is correct or incorrect. Are you getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
So first, I will be writing the expressions of KSP. Now you see, first option you are having AgCN. Now AgCN will be giving Ag plus and CN minus. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And it is CN minus is a salt of a weak acid. CN minus is an anion of a weak acid. So it will undergo hydrolysis. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So you see, if there was only AgCN in water, then S will be equal to under root of KSP. Yes?
Yes, sir.
But if hydrolysis is taking place, if hydrolysis of CN minus is considered, then S will be greater than under root of KSP. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. Once again, could you repeat?
See, if only AgCN is there and we are not considering hydrolysis of CN minus, then this will be S and this will also be S?
Yes, sir.
But now some of this S is dissociating to give HCN and OH minus. So it becomes S to S minus X.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you see the solubility is increasing, no? Because some of the CN minus is removed from the equilibrium. So this reaction will go in forward direction.
Yes, sir.
So the solubility is increasing. If you consider hydrolysis of CN minus, then S will be greater than under root of KSP. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Now let us see the options. Option A, 4. 4 is solubility is under root KSP. Then 2. 2 says that solubility decreases because of cation in the solution. Now, if there is a cation in the solution, then the solubility will decrease. Common ion effect. This is a universally true effect statement. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is a statement which is true. Okay. Without any relation to the problem, this is a universally true statement. Okay, so 4 is correct and 2 is also correct. Now R is saying that the solubility is unaffected by the pH of the solution. That is incorrect. Why? Because you see, when hydrolysis is taking place, you are getting OH minus. If I make the pH acidic, this means what? I am removing OH minus?
Yes, sir.
So, hydrolysis is going in forward direction?
Yes, sir.
So, this will also go in forward direction?
Solubility increases.
So, solubility should increase. It won't be unaffected. So, A is not a correct combination. Getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next option B. B is saying that solubility is greater than root KSP. Now, this means that it is... Now, solubility is greater than root KSP, okay, and it is then saying third, the solubility decreases because of presence of a common anion. Now, this is also correct, okay, because this is also representing the common anion effect statement. You see, if you are adding either Ag plus or CN minus from some other source, the solubility will be decreasing only. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
So 2 and 3 are always correct. 1 and 4 will always be incorrect.
sir.
Okay. So C is correct. Now S. Option S is anionic hydrolysis will make solubility in water greater than expected. So that is the correct statement. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So that way B is the correct option.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us talk about C. Now they have given C as the official answer, but let us look into C, whether it is correct or not. See, all this is based on logic. Okay, I don't go by the answers, I go by the logic. If the logic is looks correct to you, then only we should accept that answer. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if we look into option C, option one, okay, under solubility is greater than under root KSV. This is possible in case of AgCl. Okay. Now, when you're talking about second, one is always incorrect. So the whole combination is incorrect. Getting my point?
Yes.
Solubility will always decrease in presence of a common anion in the solution. Okay. So C is not a correct option. Okay. And D. When you are talking about D, one is correct. Okay. Three is also correct. And P is also correct. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
So D is also correct option.
Sir?
Yeah.
How can P be correct?
How can P be correct? You see, solubility increases in acidic solution. Okay. You see, if you are adding H+, it will remove this OH-.
Yes, sir.
So it will increase the hydrolysis in forward direction.
Yes, sir.
It will increase the dissociation of this in forward direction.
Yes, sir.
It will increase the solubility. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So, the correct answer for this should be B and D. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, after this, I would like to discuss 36 first because it is similar expression. Okay. In case of 36, if you are talking of PbS dissociating, it will give Pb2 plus and H2 minus. This undergoes hydrolysis to give HS minus and OH minus. Are you getting a point?
Yes.
So if only PbS dissociation is concerned, then solubility will be equal to square root of KSV. But if you are considering hydrolysis of S2 minus, then the solubility will be greater than square root of KSV. Are you getting my point? Because sulfide ion is removed by this equilibrium. Getting my point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, now let us look into the option. 1, 3, P. It will be correct. Yeah, because here it is correct. So, here also it will be correct. Same situations are there. Yes? Okay. Then 4, 3, S. Now, you see, 4 is solubility is equal to KSV. That is the correct situation here. Okay, 3 is always correct because common end effect. And S, anionic hydrolysis will make solubility more than expected. So B is also correct. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay, C, one is okay. Solubility can be greater than root KSP, but 2 is also correct. That because cause and effect statement is correct or is incorrect.
Sir,
yeah.
In 2 they mentioned cation, but they did not say that it is common cation.
Okay. They have not mentioned common cation, no. Then 2 will be also incorrect then. Are you getting a point? Because they have to mention the word common also.
So it is mentioned in question paper.
It is mentioned in the question paper.
It was mentioned, sir.
Okay. So it is only not mentioned here. See, I didn't see the question paper. Now I am seeing this paper only. Okay. So common and effect is still, applicable. See, if they have not mentioned, they have most probably typing error or something like that. Okay. So you see 2 is correct, C is 1. 1 is correct and 2 is also correct. R is incorrect. Solubility is unaffected by pH is incorrect. Are you getting my point? Because
yes,
if you are changing pH, then OH minus can be, if you are decreasing pH, then hydrolysis will increase. Okay. So R is incorrect. So C option cannot be correct. And last is 4-2P. 4 is solubility greater than equal to KSP, that is correct. 2 is this common end effect, that is also correct, and P is also correct. Because P is correct here, so it has to be correct here also. Are you getting my point? Sulfide, if you are adding H plus, then only you can make pH, decrease the pH to 3. So the hydrolysis will go in forward direction. This will also go in forward direction. So solubility will increase. Getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So D is also correct. Okay. So if these 3 are correct, then the answer should be, for 36, there should be A, B, D. Are you getting a point? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, 35. Okay. 35, AlOH whole thrice is given. So, if its solubility is S, then S moles of AlOH whole thrice will give S and 3S for AlZ plus and OH minus. Getting my point? Yes, no? The KSP will be 27 to the power 4. Yes?
Yes, sir.
So solubility will be under root of KSP and KSP by 27 to the power 1 by 4, which is the expression given in the question also. Now you see, if the solubility is greater than this volume, this means that one of the ions, either Al3 plus or OH minus, is getting consumed. Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so let us look into the options. Okay, so option number 1, A, 2, 3 and S. Now 2 is valid for this, yes. 3 is always valid, so 3 is also correct. Okay, and S is saying anionic hydrolysis will make solubility in water greater than expected. Now in this case, there is no hydrolysis. Because you are getting OH minus only. Are you getting my point? OH minus will not undergo hydrolysis. It will remain like OH minus only. Okay. So here the solubility is not more because of hydrolysis. Okay. So S option is incorrect. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we talk about B. B, option 2. It's again correct. There can be a situation in this salt where solubility is greater than KSP. This expression. 4 is incorrect. Because it is violating the common end effect principle. Okay, it is a universally incorrect statement. And Q, solubility increases in basic presence. as pH increases above 11. See, if you're adding more OH minus from outside, then due to the common end effect, what will happen? This will go in backward direction. The solubility will decrease rather than increase. So Q is also incorrect.
Yes.
Okay. So B is gone. We're not talking of C. Three. So option three can be correct. Okay. One is universally incorrect and P. Now, if you are making the pH equal to 3, means what? You are adding H plus?
Yes, sir.
So what will happen? That this will be consumed, OH minus?
Yes.
This means that this will move in forward direction, solubility will increase.
Yes, sir.
So P is correct. But you see, since one of the thing is incorrect, so the whole thing is incorrect. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
D. Now, D they have given to be the correct option. Okay, so D, 2 is correct. Okay, there can be a situation like this. 2 is also correct here because it is representing the common end effect statement. And Q is incorrect. Because if your pH is like, you are increasing the OH minus concentration, means you are increasing your pH, then solubility will decrease actually in this case. Are you getting a point?
Yes, sir.
This should be P. Okay, or this whole thing is incorrect. So this will go for delete. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, what is the answer I am not concerned with because answers change. Last time I gave like two corrections. You know, after the seven corrections which came, I gave two corrections and they were accepted. So I will give these corrections again. Let us see whether they accept it or not. Okay. But you should be knowing what is the correct process. Are you getting my point? We should only accept those statements which are logically correct, which we are able to convince ourselves. Okay. So with this, I think we have finished the paper discussion.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So only this question was something in which I have to think a bit because, you know, they have given answers which were not matching with my logic. Okay. But I think you people are also agreeing with what I have proposed in front of you people.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So I will send these for correction. So question number 34 will go for okay. So what are the questions? 34, 35, 36. Although it was a good question, but the solutions are wrong. And then 30 data is less. Okay. I'm not okay. 27. Are you sure that the concentration of acetate was mentioned?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then 27 won't go for correction. And then in this case, 25, all options are correct. A, B, C, and D. Because they are saying it is a multi-correct option. Okay, then 24, there is a correction. Okay. It should be coming out to be 8.5, not 9. Okay. And so 24 is, so this is going for a correction. This is also going for a correction. 1 minute. Okay. Some printing mistakes are there. Okay. And all other things are fine. Okay. So with this, I am finishing the paper discussion. Okay, you can go through the error notes if you want to. So thank you for attending this paper discussion. I'm just stopping the recording now. Okay.
Thank you.